Hey everybody, it's Pastor Rhonda. You know, in this day and age, there's so much going on around us that if we're not careful, fear has a way of weaseling into our life. Because, you know, every time you turn on the TV, there's images around us that could make us afraid. You know, fear of failure, fear of, you know, coronavirus, fear of being harmed by the police. There's just a lot of stuff going on right now that could make people afraid. But you know what? When it comes to us, it's different with those in the kingdom of God. We have a covenant of protection with the Most High God. The word saved, which is what we are if you've received Jesus, it includes protection. It includes provision. It includes us being taken care of everywhere we go and everything we do. This prophecy was given through Brother Kenneth Copeland, and he said this, everything is going to be all right in the household of faith. Did you hear that? Everything is going to be all right in the household of faith. Don't feed fear. Don't feed fear, because it brings trouble into your life and it puts fear in your mouth. No, quit living in that house. Get back over here in the household of faith. Feed on my word and not on the bread of sorrow. Feed on my word and everything's going to be all right. Glory to God. That's a promise from God. We have a covenant with God that no matter what the enemy throws at us, no matter what life throws at us, we're going to be okay because God is with us. God is on our side. Have no fear of this world. Another prophecy from Brother Copeland. I have overcome it. I left nothing, absolutely nothing, that faith won't overcome. Now let's stop there for just a minute. Did you hear that statement? God said, I have left nothing that your faith won't overcome. Glory to God. That means whatever life or the devil or people throw at you, God has already seen ahead and knows you're able to overcome it. Reading on, he said, I left it no power. I left it no strength. It has nothing over you. It has no thing over you. Glory to God. He's already given us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Psalms 34, verses 1 through 4. Let's look at that real quick. Psalms 34, verses 1 through 4. It says, I will bless the Lord at all times. How often? At all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Listen, if you're praising the Lord at all times and his praise is continually in your mouth, there's no time for fear. There's no room for fear. I tell you, fear brings torment. The Bible says fear brings torment. Do not let it into your life. You know, that's something that we had to teach our daughter as she was growing up. You know, no fear. And it was really funny when she was really, really little. We would try to get her to say, you know, I'm not afraid. She said, but I am afraid. Because she was just little and didn't understand faith confession, but it did make us laugh. But she, you know, she ultimately did get it. But nonetheless, you know, you cannot allow fear into your life. Fear has torment. Fear will keep you distressed. Fear will keep you worried. Fear will keep you uptight. And that is not how God intends us to live. It says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Magnify means to make it bigger in your sight. You know, when I put my glasses on or I put my contacts in, the thing that I'm looking at doesn't get any bigger. It just gets bigger in my eyes. I can see it more clearly because it's magnified. Well, I tell you, we're supposed to magnify God. We're supposed to be looking at God. It says, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me and he delivered me from all my fears. Listen, when you seek him, when you focus your eyes on him, when you meditate on Him, when you bless Him at all times, when His praise is continually in your mouth, when you magnify Him, make Him larger in your sight than the problem, then I'll tell you, He will keep you in perfect peace. Fear has no place. Your faith will rise and it will kick fear out of doors. You have not been given a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Resist fear. No fear. No fear. We win. Amen. See you next time.